need to know project environments. Project environments, we need to understand business environment. Like business environment, we will talk about this one. Business environment lesson. But as a PM, project management fundamental, you need to understand project environment. What is project environment? Two, OPA and EF. You need to understand OPA and EF. These are influences and out of your control. You are super smart. You have a PhD degree, best universities in the world. You have PMP portfolio, many certification. My friends, if these influences make you fail, these influences affect your success at your organization. You should accept them. You should analyze them. What are those factors? Internal factors. Internal factors we call OPA. OPA means grandfather, right? OPA. OPA, old people. What is most powerful things for old people? Why we respect them? Do you know? They are knowledgeable people. They are experienced people. They have long life experience and we are listening their stories. We are learning from these old people. OPA is like your company, like your company, like OPA, organizational process asset. Your company, can you access your company historical information? Previous similar project information, previous similar operations, recorded or not, records. Records, how history come? Like 1,000, 2,000 years ago, what community live in this world? How we know? Because they leave us some records. Artifacts, they leave us. We can understand history from the artifacts. 1,000 years ago, 2,000 years ago. We find many historical information from them. We can analyze old people, how they live. Historical information database, very important. You can reach lessons learned. You can reach resources history. You can reach failure projects. You can reach issues of previous projects, then current projects, don't repeat those issues. You can reach templates, old templates. And OPA include 3P. Your company policy, procedures, process. Important. Influence your project. HR policy. You will hire new staff. And hiring new staff according to your HR policy, 6 months. It will affect your project, of course. You need to wait 6 months. Procurement. Your country, your company procurement. Procure one hardware, 8 months. It will affect, yes. IT policy. Your team members' laptop broken. And you will change your laptop. But IT policy, three months, 4 months. Maybe IT, no IT policy to change laptop. So those policies, procedures affect your project. Historical information, lack of historical information affect your estimates in new projects, affect your success in your new project. Because company has no historical information. EF, external can be internal. Internal part, your organization type and your staff skills, your staff skillful experience or not. You have subject matter experts or not, subject matter experts. And organization structure, type of your organization. It affects authority, PM authority. Project managers, powerful or not powerful. Project managers, decision makers or not. organization. These are internal. And your company infrastructure. How is your internet speed at office? Are you good? This is factor. Affect your project. How is your meeting room? Can you find available meeting rooms? For example, you meet with your team, team members, project. Do you have available meeting rooms? Can you book easily? Those infrastructure affect, influence your project. External factors, market, government, if you are construction area, weather conditions, market research, external things may affect your project as well. So, please, after today, everybody knows OPA and EF. Because I will use some short name. I will say this is OPA, this is EF. OPA formula, don't forget. EF can be internal and external. Internal part, organization types, staff skills, infrastructure, your company related. So those influences out of your control. Okay. Your project can be delayed. Your project can be failed because of those. Dear PM, we don't have such power. Even CEO, this person also cannot control, influence strategies. Your project start or your programs. Why you need to understand these influences? What you will use, where you will use those. To understand this, you can analyze risk. Risk management. For risk management. If your projects, program, portfolio, you are not doing risk management, your job difficult. Risk management mandatory. We will talk process part, risk management. So aware of this for risk management. Every project we will prepare, we will write risks before starting execution. We need to identify risk. So how we can identify this model? Help us.